press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Okay, children. Subject: Social Science. Topic: Christianity and Islam. Class 6. Okay. In previous class, we study about the Christianity. Okay. In this class, we study about another religion, Islam. Islam. Okay. In this class, we study about the teachings of Prophet Muhammad. Prophet Muhammad was the founder of Islam. Who was the founder of Islam, children? Islam religion. Prophet Muhammad was the founder of Islam. Prophet Muhammad. Prophet Muhammad was the founder of the Islam. Okay, he was the person to find out the Islam religion. He was born at Mecca. Prophet Muhammad was born at Mecca. He was born at Mecca. Okay, Mecca in Arabia. A place, Mecca in Arabia. He was born at Mecca in Arabia. Prophet means the one who preaches the God's message. Prophet means what, children? One who preaches the God's messages. Okay. Believe that he is the representative of the God. Prophet Muhammad is the representative of the God. Okay. He gets some messages from the God. And those messages were spread among the people in Arabia. In Arabia, before the rise of Islam, there were several tribal communities. Several tribal groups in Arabia. Tribal groups means what, children? Guddagadu janaru anta heltare. Okay. People who moving from one place to another place. They were no unity. There were no unity among the people. There were no unity among them. So there were often quarrels. There were no unity in Arabia. In Mecca, Kaaba temple was a well-known pilgrimage center. Kaaba temple Kaaba temple is a well-known pilgrimage center. Okay. Once again, children, see here, before the rise of Islam, what happened? There were several tribal groups in Arabia. Tribal groups, people who moving from to one place to another place. There were no unity among them. Every time they were quarreling or quarrels, there were no unity. In Mecca, Kaaba temple is a well-known pilgrimage center. It is sacred place are the people. So the tribal people, they were worshipping Kaaba temple. It is a pilgrimage center. Okay. Idols were worshipped there before Islam. Before Islam became powerful. When Islam became powerful, after the Prophet Muhammad forbade the worship of the idols. Refused the worship of the idols or images. Idols were worshipped by the people. Okay. Many superstitions means blind beliefs. Okay. Many superstitions were there. Blind beliefs were there among the tribal people of Arabia. Now we study about life of Prophet Muhammad. Muhammad's father was Abdullah. Muhammad's father name was Abdullah and mother was अमीना, अमीना, ओके. His father name was Abdullah and his mother name was Amina. They were his parents. He had lost his father before his birth. Prophet Muhammad, he lost his father before his birth. Initially, he helped his uncle in business. His uncle was a business person. He was going business tours and all. Okay. Later, when he grew up, he met a rich widow by name Khadija. Khadija. Okay. So he was working under her. When he grew up, once again, initially he helped his uncle in business. His uncle was a business person. He was going business tours and all. Later, when he grew up, he met a rich widow by name Khadija. Her name was Khadija. So he was working under her. She gave him a job. Impressed by his simplicity and honesty, she married him. Khadija married Prophet Muhammad. Okay, he led a very simple life and his life was very honest. He was very honest. Okay, he led a very simple life and he was very honest. From the age of 40, Prophet Muhammad used to engage himself in prayer and meditation. In early age 40, only he started to pray the God and he spent his most of time in meditation. Then after some time he began to preach the messages of God. It believed that Prophet Muhammad used to get some messages from the God. Whatever enlightened, he gets some messages. Many thoughts were struck in his mind when he was sitting for meditation and prayer. Okay, he enlightened, he gets some messages from the God. Those messages, he was thinking that not only gave those messages and this were spread among the people. The Quran is the holy book of the Muslims. The Quran is the Quran is the Quran is the holy book of Muslims. The Quran is the holy book of the Muslims. Certain such messages, it is in Arabic language. Once again, the Quran is the holy book of the Muslims. Certain such messages, it is in Arabic language. So the messages which were given by the Prophet Muhammad were in Arabic language. Next, Islam means submission to God. Islam means what, children? Submission to God. We think that God is supreme. The God is supreme head. Muslims means one who surrendered to the God. Muslims means what, children? One who surrenders to God. Completely, they say that God is ultimate power. The God is supreme. There is nobody above him. We should be very humble to the God. Slowly his teachings was accepted by many because of his simplicity. Okay. Prophet Muhammad teachings were accepted by large number of people. Since Prophet Muhammad disapproved the existing religious blind beliefs and practices, many opposed him, leading to enmity. He used to observe many religious blind beliefs and practices. He wanted to reject these blind beliefs, practices, religious blind beliefs, and to make the religion simple. Okay. So when he said that not to follow these blind beliefs, blind beliefs, religious blind beliefs. What happened? Many people opposed him, did not like him. Okay, once again increased his enemies, because he told not to follow the blind beliefs and evil practices. So many people began to oppose him. They became his enemies. Hence he had to leave Mecca. That's why he leave Mecca and moved to Medina. He leave Mecca and went to the Medina. Okay. When his enemies increased, so he had to leave Mecca and move to the Medina, because enemies increased in Mecca, his life was not safe there. He moved to Medina. This event is known as Hijri. Okay. When Prophet Muhammad leave Mecca and moved to Medina, the event is known as Hijri. He moved from Mecca to Medina. He traveled from Mecca to Medina. It's considered as a very important event in Islam community, in Islam. And it is called as Hijri. The Muslim era of the calendar commences from that year. Okay, the people of Medina welcomed Prophet Muhammad. Now Prophet Muhammad came from Mecca to Medina. People of Medina liked him. Later Mecca was captured by them. There was a war between people of Medina and people of Mecca. Mecca was captured by the Medina people. Okay, the idols were removed. So Prophet Muhammad forgave his enemies. People began to accept his teachings, came to the opinion that the idols were should not be worshipped. Okay, so all the idols which were there, these were removed. In a short time, the Islam spread in the entire Arabia because of the simplicity in the religion. Common man could follow this Islam spread very fast in the entire Arabian countries. Kaaba is the holy place of the Muslims in Mecca. Kaaba is the holy place. Kaaba is the holy place of the Muslims in Mecca. Mecca and Medina considered as the two very sacred places of Islam, of the Muslims community, of the Muslims community. Now we study about teachings of Islam. See here children, page number 96, Kaaba. It is Kaaba, the holy place of the Muslims. Okay, next. Now we study about teachings of Islam. Moon and stars are the sacred symbols of the Islam. Okay. There is teachings of Islam. There is no other God except Allah. Okay. Muhammad is his prophet. God should not be worshipped in any idol form. Allah is the only one God. Muhammad is his prophet. Understood? Next one is, every Muslim should become a servant of God. And be honest, all human beings are equal. Merchants should not cheat. Merchant should not cheat. One should not take up money lending. One should not eat pork. Pork means what? Pig meat. One should not eat pork. Meat of pig. Pork means what, children? Meat of pig. Commit infanticide and consume alcohol. Next one is, every Muslim should pray namaz 5 times a day facing the direction of Kaaba and fast during the daytime in the month of Ramzan. The rich should compulsory give charity. Charity means zakat to the poor. The Muslims should undertake pilgrimage to Mecca, Hajj, at least once in their life. ಅಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಇವಾಗ ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಧರ್ಮದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಪೈಗಂಬರರು ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಧರ್ಮದ ಸ್ಥಾಪಕರು. ಅವರು ಅರಬ್ ದೇಶದ ಮೆಕ್ಕಾ ನಗರದಲ್ಲಿ ಜನಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಪೈಗಂಬರ ಎಂದರೆ ದೇವರ ಸಂದೇಶವನ್ನು ಸಾರುವವರು, ಪ್ರವಾದಿ. ಪ್ರವಾದಿ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಪೈಗಂಬರರು. ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಪೂರ್ವದ ಅರಬ್ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನೇಕ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಪುಟ್ಟ ಪಂಗಡಗಳಿದ್ದವು. ಅಂದರೆ ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಪೂರ್ವದಲ್ಲಿ ಅರಬ್ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನೇಕ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಪಂಗಡಗಳು ಇದ್ದವು. ಅವುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಒಗ್ಗಟ್ಟಿರಲಿ, ಅಂದರೆ ಸಣ್ಣ ಪುಟ್ಟ ಪಂಗಡಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಆವಾಗ ನೋಡಬಹುದಿತ್ತು. ಅಂದರೆ ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಧರ್ಮದ ಉಗಮದ ಹಿಂದೆ, ಅದರ ಹಿಂದೆ, ಅದು ಹುಟ್ಟಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆ ಅರಬ್ಬಿನ ಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಹೇಗಿತ್ತು ಎಂಬುದನ್ನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಅರಬ್ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಪೂರ್ವದ ಅರಬ್ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನೇಕ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಪುಟ್ಟ ಪಂಗಡಗಳು ಇದ್ವು. ಅವುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಒಗ್ಗಟ್ಟಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಅವರು ಮೆಕ್ಕಾದಲ್ಲಿದ್ದ ಕಾಬಾ ಮಂದಿರದ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಯಾತ್ರಾ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರವಾಗಿದೆ, ಹೌದಲ್ವಾ? ಮೆಕ್ಕಾದಲ್ಲಿದ್ದ ಕಾಬಾ ಮಂದಿರವು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಯಾತ್ರಾ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರವಾಗಿತ್ತು. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವಿಗ್ರಹಾರಾಧನೆ ರೂಢಿಯಲ್ಲಿತ್ತು. ಯಾವಾಗ? ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಧರ್ಮದ ಉಗಮದ ಹಿಂದೆ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಧರ್ಮದ ಪೂರ್ವದಲ್ಲಿ ಅರಬ್ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನೇಕ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಪುಟ್ಟ ಪಂಗಡಗಳು ಇದ್ವು. ಅವುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಒಗ್ಗಟ್ಟಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಅವ್ರು ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಜಗಳವನ್ನು, ಅಂದರೆ ಪರಸ್ಪರ ಜಗಳವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು. ಮೆಕ್ಕಾದಲ್ಲಿದ್ದ ಕಾಬಾ ಮಂದಿರವು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಯಾತ್ರಾ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರವಾಗಿತ್ತು. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವಿಗ್ರಹ ಆರಾಧನೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು, ರೂಢಿಯಲ್ಲಿತ್ತು. ಯಾವಾಗ ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಧರ್ಮದ ಉಗಮ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ? ಪ್ರವಾದಿ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದರು ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ, ಅಂದರೆ ವಿಗ್ರಹ ಆರಾಧನೆಯನ್ನು ಖಂಡಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ನಾವು ಪ್ರವಾದಿ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದರ ಜೀವನದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಇವಾಗ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದರ ತಂದೆ ಅಬ್ದುಲ್ಲಾ, ಇವರ ತಂದೆ ಹೆಸರು ಅಬ್ದುಲ್ಲಾ, ಇವರ ತಾಯಿಯ ಹೆಸರು ಅಮೀನಾ. ಅವರು ಹುಟ್ಟುವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಮುನ್ನವೇ ತಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆಯನ್ನು ಅವರು ಕಳೆದುಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರು. ಯಾರು? ಪ್ರವಾದಿ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್. ಪ್ರಾರಂಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರು ಚಿಕ್ಕಪ್ಪನಿಗೆ ವ್ಯಾಪಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಹಾಯವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ನೆರವಾಗ ತೊಡಗ್ತಾರೆ. ನಂತರ ಮುಂದೆ ಅವರು ದೊಡ್ಡವರಾದ ನಂತರ ಖದೀಜಾ ಎಂಬ ಧನಿಕ ಶ್ರೀಮಂತ ವಿಧವೆಯೊಬ್ಬಳು ಇವರನ್ನು ತನ್ನ ವ್ಯಾಪಾರದ ಪ್ರತಿನಿಧಿಯಾಗಿ ನೇಮಿಸಿಕೊಂಡರು. ಮುಂದೆ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದರ ಸರಳತೆ ಮತ್ತು ಪ್ರಾಮಾಣಿಕತೆಯನ್ನು ಮೆಚ್ಚಿಕೊಂಡು ಅವರನ್ನು ಮದುವೆಯಾಗ್ತಾರೆ. ತಮ್ಮ 40ನೇ ವಯಸ್ಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರವಾದಿ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದರು ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮತ್ತು ಧ್ಯಾನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರು ಮಗ್ನರಾಗಿ ಇರುತ್ತಿದ್ದರು. ಕಾಲ ಸರಿದಂತೆ ದೇವರ ಸಂದೇಶಗಳನ್ನು ಸಾರಲು ಅವರು ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂತಹ ದಿವ್ಯ ಸಂದೇಶಗಳನ್ನು ಒಳಗೊಂಡ ಗ್ರಂಥವೇ ಇಸ್ಲಾಮಿನ ಮೂಲ ಗ್ರಂಥ ಕುರಾನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇದು ಅರೇಬಿಕ್ ಭಾಷೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ. ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಪದದ ಅರ್ಥ ಶರಣಾಗತಿ. ಮುಸ್ಲಿಂ ಎಂದರೆ ದೇವರಿಗೆ ಶರಣಾದವರು ಎಂದು ಅರ್ಥ. ಕಾಲಕ್ರಮೇಣ ಪ್ರವಾದಿ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದರ ಅನುಯಾಯಿಗಳ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಕಾಲದ ಧಾರ್ಮಿಕ ಆಚಾರ ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ಅವರು ಟೀಕಿಸುತ್ತಿದ್ದರಿಂದ ಅವರ ವಿರೋಧಿಗಳ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆಯೂ ಕೂಡ ಏನಾಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ? ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ, ಬೆಳೆಯುತ್ತೆ. ಹೀಗಾಗಿ ಅವರು ಮೆಕ್ಕಾದಿಂದ ಮದೀನಾ ನಗರಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಪ್ರವಾದಿಯವರು ಮೆಕ್ಕಾದಿಂದ ಮದೀನಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದ ವರ್ಷದಿಂದಲೇ ಮುಸಲ್ಮಾನರ ಹಿಜರೀಷಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರಾರಂಭ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಮದೀನಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಜನರು ಪ್ರವಾದಿ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದರನ್ನು ಸ್ವಾಗತಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಮುಂದೆ ಅವರು ಮೆಕ್ಕಾವನ್ನು ಗೆದ್ದುಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ. ತನ್ನ ಶತ್ರುಗಳನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಅವರು ಕ್ಷಮಿಸ್ತಾರೆ, ಕ್ಷಮೆ ನೀಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿದ್ದ ವಿಗ್ರಹಗಳನ್ನು ಅವರು ತೆಗೆಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಲ್ಪಕಾಲದಲ್ಲೇ ಇಡೀ ಅರಬ್ ದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಧರ್ಮ ಹರಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಇಸ್ಲಾಮಿನ ಬೋಧನೆಗಳು. ಅಲ್ಲಾನ ಹೊರತು ಬೇರೆ ದೇವರಿಲ್ಲ. ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಅವರು ದೇವರ ಪ್ರವಾದಿ. ದೇವರನ್ನು ಯಾವ ಮೂರ್ತಿಯ ರೂಪದಲ್ಲೂ ಪೂಜಿಸಬಾರದು. ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಮುಸಲ್ಮಾನನು ದೇವರ ಸೇವಕನಾಗಬೇಕು. ಪ್ರಾಮಾಣಿಕನಾಗಿರಬೇಕು, ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾನವರು ಸಮಾನರು ಎಂದು ಬೋಧಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ವ್ಯಾಪಾರಿಗಳು ಮೋಸ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು, ಬಡ್ಡಿ ವ್ಯವಹಾರ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು, ಶಿಶು ಹತ್ಯೆ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು, ಹಂದಿ ಮಾಂಸವನ್ನು ತಿನ್ನುವುದು ಮತ್ತು ಮದ್ಯಪಾನ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು ಎಂದು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಮದ್ಯಪಾನ ಸಲ್ಲದು. ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಮುಸಲ್ಮಾನನು ಅಂದರೆ ಬಡ್ಡಿ ವ್ಯಾಪಾರ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು, ಶಿಶು ಹತ್ಯೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು, ಹಂದಿ ಮಾಂಸವನ್ನು ತಿನ್ನಬಾರ್ದು, ಮದ್ಯಪಾನವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು, ವ್ಯಾಪಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಮೋಸವನ್ನು ವ್ಯಾಪಾರಿಗಳು ಮೋಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು ಎಂದು ಪ್ರವಾದಿ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್, ಪ್ರಾಫೆಟ್ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಬೋಧಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಮುಸಲ್ಮಾನನು ದಿನಕ್ಕೆ 5 ಬಾರಿ ಕಾಬಾದ ದಿಕ್ಕಿಗೆ ಮುಖ ಮಾಡಿ ನಮಾಜ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ರಂಜಾನ್ ತಿಂಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಹಗಲು ಉಪವಾಸ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಶ್ರೀಮಂತರು ಬಡವರಿಗೆ ಕಡ್ಡಾಯವಾಗಿ ದಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಜಕಾತ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ದಾನವನ್ನು ನೀಡಬೇಕು, ಜಕಾತನ್ನು ನೀಡಬೇಕು. ಸಾಧ್ಯವಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಜೀವಮಾನದಲ್ಲಿ 1 ಬಾರಿಯಾದರೂ, 1 ಸಲವಾದರೂ ಹಜ್ ಯಾತ್ರೆಯನ್ನು ಕೈಗೊಳ್ಳಬೇಕು, ಹಜ್ ಯಾತ್ರೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಎಂದು ಬೋಧಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಯಾರು? ಪ್ರವಾದಿ ಮುಹಮ್ಮದ್. ಓಕೆ, ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಪೈಗಂಬರರು ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಧರ್ಮದ ಸ್ಥಾಪಕರು. ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಪೈಗಂಬರರು ಇಸ್ಲಾಂ ಧರ್ಮದ ಸ್ಥಾಪಕರು. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್.